Hey everyone, so glad you guys are here today. Got a great lesson for you guys. We're going to be answering the question, does God speak to us today? And if he does, how does he do that? I'll see you guys after the songs.
It's Romans 1:16.
For I am not ashamed of the gospel.
Romans 1:16.
Hey guys, welcome back. I hope you guys enjoyed those songs. Before we get started, I want to wish you guys a very happy new year. And I hope this year is a whole lot better than last year. Well, we're going to get right into our lesson today. And during the introduction, I asked you guys, does God speak to us today? Well, the answer is yes, and we're going to find out how God did that. But we're going to go back in time a little bit and find out how God spoke to people in different ways. Our story today is found in 1 Samuel chapter 3. It's verses 1 through 20, so if you want to get your Bibles, go ahead and get them. Or I encourage you guys to read that story sometime this week. But I'm going to go ahead and read it to you right now. It's a story of a boy named Samuel, and I think you guys have heard this lesson before. It says, Samuel served the Lord under a man named Eli. You see, in those days, the Lord did not speak directly to people very often, but this was one of those times where he did. Eli was in bed sleeping, and Samuel was in another room sleeping as well. Then the Lord called Samuel, and Samuel answered, and he said, I am here. Except he ran to Eli, and he said, I am here. You called me, Eli. But Eli says, I didn't call you, Samuel. Go back to bed. So Samuel went back to bed. The Lord called him again, Samuel. Samuel again went to Eli and he said, I am here. You called me. Again, Eli said, I didn't call you, Samuel. Go back to bed. Samuel did not yet know the Lord. The Lord had not spoken directly to him yet. Then the Lord called Samuel for a third time. Samuel got up and he went to Eli and he said, I am here, you called me. Then Eli realized that the Lord was calling Samuel. It wasn't Eli, it was the Lord. And he told Samuel, he said, go back to bed. If he calls you again, then answer him this way. Speak, Lord, I am your servant. And I am listening. So Samuel went and he went back to bed. And then the Lord came and stood there and he called Samuel again. He said, Samuel, Samuel. Samuel said, speak, Lord, I am your servant and I am listening. So back then, God spoke with a voice that you can actually hear out loud. But the question is, how does God speak to you and I even today? And that's what we're going to talk about. First of all, what I want you guys to know is that God speaks to us through His Word. And His Word is the Bible. It's for us. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 says that all Scripture is God-breathed. It's given to us by God Himself. In this book, you'll find warnings. In this book, you'll find encouragement, lessons for life, and many other things. God speaks to us through His Word, but more specifically, He speaks to us through His Son, Jesus. In Hebrews chapter 1, verses 1 and 2, listen to what it says. In the past, God spoke to our forefathers through the prophets at many times and in many different ways. But in these last days, He has spoken to us by His Son. Guys, in this book, in His Word, in Scripture, are the words of Jesus. When we read Jesus' words, we can actually kind of hear God's heart, and we can know God's voice by what the Bible tells us. You know, guys, that even the Bible says that nature speaks. That's right. The trees, the mountains, the skies, they actually speak. Now, it's not one of those voices where you're going to understand, but this is what it says. Romans chapter 1, verse 20. There are things about God that people cannot see. His eternal power and all things that make Him God. But since the beginning of the world, those things have been easy to understand. They are made clear by what God has made. So people have no excuse for the bad things that they do. You know, we can't see God, boys and girls, but we know that we have a creator. And all we got to do is walk outside and see the sun, the moon, the stars, the trees, and the wind, and the ocean. And we know God speaks to us that He is alive and He created all things. In Psalms chapter 19, it says, "The heavens tell or speak the glory of God, and the skies announce what his hands have made." So again, God speaks to us through his Bible, through his Son, and even in nature. Another way God speaks to us is through other believers. You know, when you come to church and you listen to the pastor preaching or teaching the Bible, God is speaking to you that way. Also through good music, and also with the Holy Spirit. You know, when I read about Samuel, there was a part that says that he did not yet know the Lord. When you become a Christian, the Holy Spirit comes inside of you and you begin to know the Lord and you know his word. And you know what? God speaks to us through his Spirit, and he goes towards the conscience, and he directs us, and he helps us to make the right decisions. So guys, be encouraged that God speaks to us in many different ways. And once again, you're probably not going to hear a loud voice and out of nowhere. God speaks to us through his word, through Jesus, through other people, through nature, and all those things. And guys, I encourage you to get into the word and read it and study it and get to know God and know him good. He is a good God. Well, right now, Miss Kristen's gonna come up. She's got a story to share with you guys, but I'm glad you guys are here, and I'll see you guys again next week. Bye for now.
Hey everybody, it is time for today's life story. I've got a great story for you guys, so let's get started. How many of you guys have a dog? Well, we're gonna learn a story today about Maria, and she has a dog. She loves her dog. Her dog's name is Snowflake, and she loves to take him out to the park and to go running. But Snowflake, although he's a good dog, he doesn't listen all the time to Maria. So she would yell for him to come, and he would run the other way, and it was quite frustrating for her. So let's see what happens. Maria went to her mom and said, "Mom, Snowflake doesn't listen to me no matter what I do. He runs away, and I'm afraid he's gonna get lost." So her mom said to her, "Well, Maria, why don't you put Snowflake on a leash? A leash will keep him safe and keep him close." She said, "Well, I don't wanna keep him on a leash. I wanna let him have fun and run around and do all the things that dogs do." So her mom said, "Well, here's a leash, and maybe just think about it. I think it would be best." So let's see what happens. Maria thought about it, and she thought, "Well, mom's probably right." So she went over to Snowflake with the leash to put it on, and she called him. But Snowflake was too distracted. He was chasing around a bluebird, and she kept calling him and calling him, but he was not paying any attention. So let's see what happens. Well, she started to go after him with a leash because she knew it would be best, but when she did, he ran away even further and chased the bird till she didn't even see where he was anymore. So she called after him, "Snowflake, Snowflake," but he was gone. It was too late. And let's see what happens. Well, Mom saw what happened, and she saw Maria over there, and Maria was crying. You see, Maria was really sad because she loved her dog Snowflake, and she was very worried about where the dog was going to be and what was going to happen. She says, "Mom, he just wouldn't listen to me. I don't know what to do anymore." So Mom and Maria went looking for Snowflake, but it started to get dark, and they didn't find him yet, so they were going to have to wait till the next morning. Maria was so sad. Her mom told her, "Maria, we're gonna go home, but I'm gonna encourage you to go up to your room and talk to God about it. Let's tell God what's going on, because he can speak to you." And Maria thought, "He can speak to me?" She says, "It's not gonna be a voice like mine, but God speaks to us. He speaks to us by his Holy Spirit and through his word." So let's see what happens. Maria went home, and she went up to her room just like Mom said. And she prayed and prayed till she fell asleep. But the next morning she was up the first sign of the sun. She got dressed quickly, said bye Mom, and ran out the door because she was going to try to find Snowflake. She was gonna look everywhere she could for him. She searched and she searched, but she didn't find him. She asked everybody she saw, "Have you seen a small white poodle? Their name is Snowflake. Have you seen him anywhere?" And the people had said, "No, I'm sorry." She even went to all of her neighbors and knocked on the door. She went everywhere she could think of, but she couldn't find Snowflake. Her heart was very sad, But she didn't stop praying to God either. She would pray every day and she would listen for God's voice and his peace. And let's see what happens. Well, she went down to the park about a week after this happened, and as she was walking, all of a sudden, before her eyes, there was Snowflake. There was her friend from school too, it was Johnny, and he had Snowflake on a leash. She ran up and said, "Snowflake!" And she was so excited to see her puppy that she had been looking for and praying for. And Johnny kind of looked a little confused. She says, "Do you know this dog?" And she said, "Yes, this is my dog. I lost him and I couldn't find him anywhere. Thank you. But how did you get him to stay on the leash and stay so close?" So let's see what happens. Well, Johnny said, "I found him and I got him right away and I put him on the leash. You see, my dad's a dog trainer. And so we have to give instructions and we have to teach. And I have to listen to what my dad tells me so that I can do it for the dogs." And Maria thought about it. She said, "Well, could you help me? Learn about how to teach Snowflake and help him to listen to me?" And Johnny said, "Sure." He says, "But you can't just let him run around without a leash. You gotta keep him on that leash and keep him close. It's best for you and me." And so Johnny began to tell Maria all the ways that she could keep Snowflake safe and also how she could train him. And boys and girls, you know what? God speaks to us. He speaks to us through his word. He speaks to us through the Holy Spirit. And he speaks to us through other people, through godly people, moms and dads. He speaks to us through pastors and Sunday school teachers and other people who love God. So when we have things that we need to hear from God about, we should talk to people who know God's word and love him. You see, Maria was talking to Johnny. And Johnny knew how to train a dog because his dad had trained him and he had knowledge and wisdom. And when we need to hear from God's voice, when we need to hear him, we should speak to people who also have that wisdom, people who understand the Bible, people who know and love God and want what's best for us, just like Maria did with Johnny. And let's see what happens. Well, Maria was excited to try out and see if what Johnny really told her was gonna work. So she got down on her knees and she started to give Snowflake the instructions. And guess what? It worked. She couldn't believe it. Johnny was instructing her while she was doing it and training her and teaching her. And boys and girls, that's like us through life. God wants to instruct us. He wants to train us and he wants to teach us. And he does that through speaking to us through his word, by the Holy Spirit, and through godly people. So let's see what happens. Well, Maria was so excited. She couldn't wait to go home and tell mom that she found Snowflake and to take all of this stuff that she had learned so she could train Snowflake so he would be safe and that he would listen to her. And she was so excited. She was so happy that she had listened to Johnny. But more importantly, she was also learning how she can listen to God and how important that is in her life as well. And boys and girls, that's important for all of us, even us grown-ups. We need to learn how to listen to God's voice, to be patient and trust him. Well, I hope you guys have a great week. We love you guys so much. It's Happy New Year. So we look forward to 2021 and we look forward to spending more time with you. We love you guys and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.